last time we were all together. Unless well, Bob and I were together. We went on a tour.
It was just the two of you.
I don't think. Well, no. Bill. No. Charlie. Who else?
Lieutenant.
Oh, and Lieutenant Erasmus was there too. So we got to see the new station up in Farmington. I have to tell you, very impressive.
Did you take any pictures of radios by chance?
Of radios?
No, videos.
Oh, no.
No, it was, we thought about asking to take pictures, but kind of secure location, so I don't know how keen they would have been on us taking pictures inside there. But it was mostly just checking out the design and checking with people who are actually working in the building, if they're actually satisfied with the product. And everyone, the only complaints was how the building was set up, and that was on them. It wasn't sort of the flow of traffic in the building, but that was not a design flaw by the folks building it. It was the people working in the building that said this is how they wanted it set up. The energy costs were what? Was it cut down by a third or a quarter? I'm trying to remember. About
well, they anticipate should be 50% less, but right now they're saying for sure it's going to be at least one third less than their current expenditures for energy.
So you'd probably have savings in general, but maybe the type of building it is even more so. Because, I mean, clearly something like this, you're going to have an energy savings just by moving out. But
yeah, this is a much more porous building than
Was the approximate square footage about the same? Or
they have a
by about double, maybe?
Almost double,
yeah.
Because they're a combination of police and fire, but even their police size will be larger than ours. The only thing they don't have is they don't have a garage as of yet. They do have a Sally Book, but they don't have a garage to store their vehicles.
Mm-hmm. So. The architect and the builder, I'm trying to think of the vice president, maybe, or the third or second in line after his dad, maybe. Was on hand, which was very helpful. Explained the process and how they go about actually erecting these buildings. They take into consideration, you know, what we want, which was nice as well, in the design phase. So compared to some of the other companies that just sort of sent us, I don't know, not as complete plans. I mean, the Gruen folks sent us super nuts, basically, right? With everything you could imagine we would need. Site work the faucets, the fittings for the building. So it was really, it was an impressive presentation. So.
Is it insulated walls?
Yeah. And they, I left my folder, I think, in my office. I took it to check out. It's rated to, it was like a category four, three or four hurricane. I mean, these are substantial buildings. They're certainly would stand up to just about anything we'd have here in the room.
Is it the type of the foam in between concrete or opposite?
No, the foam is on the outside of the concrete. The concrete, you have 8 inches of concrete, then you have 2.5 inches of foam on the inside, and 2.5 inches of foam on the outside all the way around.
And then whatever kind of exterior
siding that you have.
Well, what would the options for that for exterior?
Well, we would just be looking at something that's low mail, obviously very low maintenance, you know, vinyl siding or something like that.
Would it
be wood, yeah. The idea is to have very low maintenance as possible. Just knowing the history of how things have happened in town in the past.
Well, Bob and I were talking about that. The next step really would be to make a recommendation to the select board. Yeah, and we've pretty much exhausted the options looking at them. There were three different designs that were submitted.
Right, we had a regular stick built on site from Middleton, and we had the modular build, which they built it off site. Mm-hmm. They chucked it in and put it down by a crane from New England Homes, and then you have the folks from Gruen with the ICF. So you have three different types of construction. All the same price range. The modular was a little bit less than the other two, so.
But it didn't include all the site work, did it?
It did, it was everything.
That one did, okay.
That one was supplemental as well.
Okay.
And again, those are just estimates at this point. I think the next step would be to add, recommend to the board that they seek a, an RFP, request for proposals based upon, you know, my initial drawing and what we needed for a particular room, whatever the case might be, and submit that to the board. And then they can come in and, you know, give their presentation to the board and say, well, this is why it costs this much, this is what we're planning on doing, blah, 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 blah. And then, have a public hearing and or, you know, talk about whatever it costs people as we go through the budget process between now and March, and, I mean, who knows.
So you would have a public hearing after the request for proposal goes through, or do you have it with us and then it goes to the board? Is it after the select board? Is it? I'm not sure that I understand the whole process.
This group would make a recommendation to
without
the board, without a public hearing.
Okay.
The goal of this group is to sort of fact-finding, gathering the information, the select board will hold the public hearing, and let people know.
Okay.
Say, this is crazy, or this is a good idea, or somewhere in between, maybe, who knows, hopefully. That's what we would hope would be the process.
So, is it this committee to recommend having it police and administration, or is it the board of selectmen to make that decision as well?
Ultimately, it would be up to the select board to make the recommendation then to the town meeting. We would ultimately make the decision how they like to proceed.
Mm-hmm.
This group was charged with coming up with a solution for the police.
Right.
Recognizing though that right now it's one building, so we did. You know, we would look at other options if one presented itself. Didn't seem to be, at least at the meeting before last, not the last one was a tour, the one before that, it seemed that most folks, because we did take some public comment, were inclined to believe that it would be a bad idea to combine them and try to sell it to the town. I don't, that's not my opinion, that's just what we said by the majority of people that showed up. So
one of the things I had suggested, but it doesn't seem like it's kind of going to happen. So it sounds like the only option we're bringing to the public is building. One of the options I have mentioned is space sharing, but it doesn't seem like any investigation has
space sharing with another department. Mm-hmm. We have. That's where it was. Charlie
with
was here.
Another police department.
Oh. Charlie has been working on has been meeting with the department area chiefs,
mm-hmm,
and looking at. I don't know if he talked about space sharing. No, Bob.
I think it was contracting out services.
Yeah,
And it wasn't cost effective.
Which is a different option.
Right, no, for sure. They, I don't believe any of the chiefs indicated that they had the space to incorporate Rollinsford, but I'd have to leave it to Charlie to answer whether or not he actually has that question. I don't know.
Yeah, I mentioned, like, Garland and Sudbrook were talking about sharing a space.
Mm-hmm.
So why would we not consider that as an option going to the public? If it were viable.
But they're sharing a space and going in, they're creating a new police station. Mm-hmm. So they're going in with that already in their mind.
Yep.
You're probably considering doing something that already exists. And they're probably already at their max or not enough to pick up a whole department in there. I mean, I can't imagine Summersworth isn't that big, and they wouldn't be able to pick up your whole department.
Based upon, you know, what I know working with Dover, that we would not be welcome there.
Yeah.
You know, to work there every day.
Right, right.
And I probably think with Summersworth as well, because, right, you know, we do things a little bit differently than Summersworth does, mm-hmm, and Dover does things a little bit differently than Dover does,
mm-hmm,
and whatnot. You're asking Rollinsford officers to go into their territory,
mm-hmm,
you know, their space, and then do what we need to do. I mean, we have different computer systems, you know, because we're connected with the county. Summersworth isn't connected with the county. Dover doesn't even use the same computer program that most of the state does, and they certainly aren't connected to the county. So, you know, it would be losing a lot of information by doing that.
And we wouldn't be able to cross.
Well, there's assumptions that you couldn't solve that problem technically, though. I just think it's pretty close.
I know, but you're still looking at, you know, shift changes, I mean, you know, different, you know, we work different shifts than they do, you know. Do we attend their briefings, do they attend our briefings,
no.
I mean, you know.
No, I was thinking it would be a completely independent operation, just, you know, sharing space.
I don't think it would be, I think with the Southwark and the Berwick, it would be their hours, it would be theirs because they're planning it together and they're doing this together. I think Bob hit it. It would be us going to their station and utilizing their station and their equipment and their, you know, resources, and it will never be a home for Rollinsford. It will be a visitor at somebody else's station. I personally, I don't think that would work. If it was, you know, all of this ahead of time and thought about it, possibly when building something, you could have done it together. But I don't think that would work. And especially because we don't do the same services, it's the same dispatch center, it's the same computers. It's just, I know it could possibly get changed, but I just don't know if they would even be willing to do that. You know?
Well, see, and I don't think we should make assumptions. I think we should have a conversation and be prepared to answer that on the hearing, because it will come up. You know, regional services are becoming more common. Even Bill said, you know, Bill's been talking about regional services as well.
And I think that's why we...
You weren't talking about regional services. You were talking about utilizing the same building. Regional services is contracted.
Right, and that's what we have been looking at.
That's regional services. That's different. And
that's a similar concept, though.
Not really. You're just saying, I get to have that office over there, do you look for my police office just to use it? That's not regional services. Regional services is saying, your patrolman is going to cover my town this many hours in a day, this many hours at night. That's regional services.
And we cover your,
and we cover
your
yours
town.
Or whatever. Yeah. That's a different concept altogether than sharing a police station.
And that's what Charlie has been, he's had a conversation with the state police, with, I can't remember the chief's name, Chief Colarusso and Joe, I can't remember Summers.
Chris Meyer.
Thank you. They've all changed since then, someone knew. So, and the preliminary conversation is just not cost effective. So.
Right.
I get that part. I do understand that part. But I just think that it's important that we have an answer when it comes up in public hearing.
And I think we do, because we have been looking at that. So.
Well, I feel like if you go to public hearing, somebody brings up, we don't have an answer, you're not going to have support at that meeting. Mm-hmm. You know, if you have the answer, if they say no, we already talked to them, they don't want to do it, then people only have that one option to consider. But I don't think we should necessarily keep pushing this out. We want it to go to this town meeting, next town meeting. We don't want there to be open questions.
Mm-hmm. Well, I think it's very simple. I mean, I think Charlie can just throw the question out to the two chiefs and say, hey,
yep.
Right.
Can Rollinsford use your space?
Yeah.
If yes,
right, space or whatever. Mm-hmm.
Or if no,
okay. Yeah. Right.
So.
And then the question's answered. Yeah. And then if it comes up at public hearing, we've investigated that option, and it's not an option. And then they know this is our choice. And there really are other, well, and so, you know, can we answer the question of public hearing of existing buildings, any other existing buildings in town? Nothing. Bloom, like the Bloom building.
That's privately
owned.
That's going to be commercial.
It's being converted as we speak, actually.
We're working on that as we speak, yeah.
So no space for leasing, nothing.
Not there, anyway. It's going to be commercial and residential there. But commercial, like restaurant commercial, not. Please hold me, anyways.
I can't think of anything that would be.
I will just mention, since the last meeting, I did approach Brian Wentworth from the Wentworth family.
Yep.
And say, I'm not here officially. I'm just throwing this out to see if there's any possibility there be any dialogue between the town and your family about doing a land swap for the piece of property over here off of Main Street,
mm-hmm.
for the piece that the town owns way back in the woods out there.
Yep.
And Brian said that he would talk to his parents about that and get back to us. And that was about 4 weeks ago, and I haven't heard back yet. So
you're talking about with a make sure I understand where it is, where the cornfield is right now.
The cornfield, once you turn into Greenville Drive, right there.
Okay, versus the one that you looked at.
So he said, what about a number? I said, how about 10 acres for 10 acres? Just to throw the ballpark out there, just, what do you think?
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, the town would retain the section closest to the road right there.
Mm-hmm.
And then they could have the other 10 acres out there someplace. But,
mm-hmm.
but I imagine I may hear from them sometime in the next couple of weeks.
Mm-hmm.
If not, then I'm just assuming that the family is like, probably then we shouldn't do it.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah.
Well, even if if that could happen, or if we use the lot on Silver Street, are we thinking that the Grun design of the what's the acronym? Thank you. ICF is the direction we want to go with, or is it the modular or the stick build? I know how I feel, but
I think it was
ICF. I see if I would get it wrong. So.
Are there any incentives for green building?
We actually talked about that.
To a certain degree. When you go through the LEED process, it's very expensive up front because you have to guarantee that the source is local and that chemicals and I mean, it's all natural and whatever it's all energy efficient and cost effective and all that. The folks that did the building in Farmington said that building there, the way it's designed, is so energy efficient that you really be spending extra money wastefully to do the LEED process to acquire almost the exact same thing.
So the payback would take a little bit.
Yeah.
Now, are you talking about lighting and all of that as being energy efficient and stuff? Because
yes.
I know that Idlehurst, when they built Badhurst, built that. Sounds good. A lot of money for energy efficiencies and through grants and stuff.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it should be something at least look into it. It can be,
Went with, now there's nothing to say we would actually go with Grun as a company, if they came back with the best proposal for the design we're looking for.
Mm-hmm.
One of the services they provide, the project manager,
mm-hmm.
and they actually said they explore all of those options for us, so that's two. So Charlie, before you showed up, we were just talking, trust me, I get it. So we're talking about contracted services, or contracting out services. But Kim brought up another interesting aspect of that I don't think we really thought about, but renting space out from the departments. You didn't have a conversation with those. Would you be willing to ask the chiefs that you spoke with? Yeah.
Really would only be those two towns that would be close enough to consider it.
Right. So it's only really Somersworth because we can't cross the state lines, right?
Yeah, correct.
Somersworth and Dover, yeah.
Somersworth and Dover. We can't take a prison from straight lines.
There are all kinds of certification issues and so
correct.
It would make it hard.
Mm-hmm.
See, we're not CLIA certified. Dover is CLIA certified. I mean, our rules and regulations set up to be CLIA certified. It just means that you meet national standards. Folks at CLIA set up these national standards that when you book somebody, you'll process them this way. Your police cars will be set up this way for officer safety and prison safety. So they have all these rules and regulations that govern almost every aspect of police work.
Meets almost works.
All of our policies are CLIA standard. However, we don't go through the CLIA process because it's a very expensive process.
Mm-hmm.
So,
and there's some requirements for the physical plant that a little bit expensive to deal with. You do get a small insurance benefit from your insurance premiums go down a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
If you're concerned about it.
Mm-hmm.
Probably not enough to meet the offset of the cost of actually doing the certification. But.
No, but everything that the chief is doing with the policies is, in my view, just the right thing.
Okay, so you will look into that for us.
So the idea would be we would continue to have a municipal force, we would rent out space in the larger headquarters for our officers and the command staff. And we would continue to provide our own cruisers and
mm-hmm.
But do you think that they would want some sort of requirements around what we would be? Or do you have a model that we would be space and that case?
Well, do you guys have an office, or a patrolman have to have, at least the sergeant has to have an office. We have to maintain our own room for central records, because that's all CJIS required, which has to be separate from theirs. So, you're talking probably 2,000 to 3,000 square feet alone just for that.
I'm thinking of office space, like if they had office space available, you need at least 10 spaces.
At least.
And shame on me, but one of the things that surprised me is I think everybody is maintaining paper records in addition to the electronic records, which, again, shame on me. I thought we were in the 21st century.
You only have to have one paper physical copy, though, right? Instead of multiples, like you used to. Baby steps. They're working their way up to. Working their way up to it. So.
One of the other questions that we kind of put out was, are there any buildings in town that could be leased? That would make sense. Obviously, just once we have this, but we didn't come up with anything, but just as a thought.
But that might involve some arrangement with either the sheriff or another agency for your booking facility, because for booking, you do need, there's some architectural requirements for that, aren't there?
Yeah, I mean, I think that you'd have to do structural changes even if you found a building, but is there something that could be considered?
That would be, I wouldn't know where to start on that.
I agree.
We couldn't go up. The only building really we could think about would be Blue One, and that's already undergoing another transformation. Mm-hmm. So, just with the planning board last month. He's coming again this month. So. He's got other plans.
So, Tyler, the reason I brought up the space sharing idea, I think it's important that when we go to public hearing that we've done our homework. Mm-hmm. So if it comes up, have we considered outsourcing this by sharing, or we have the answers and we don't have to push it out for another hearing. That we are not stalled because there are open questions in that hearing.
I'm happy to make the inquiry. I think both chiefs were also happy to meet with either the committee or other members of the committee. And I'm not sure they want to meet with all of us one at a time. But
right.
They were incredibly gracious for the time.
I will mention that I was approached by one council member from Zumsworth who had heard about your conversation with Chief Richmond. And his position was hell no way.
That's what, yeah.
Because of what Rawlinsford did with the school system over there. There's no way that the city of Zumsworth, it just has opinion now, would ever do anything to help out the town of Rawlinsford.
I'm not surprised by that comment.
So.
I'm not surprised by that. And,
okay, and that's just one person on the city council.
I know.
So I'm just,
I think that's just the right way to.
I happen to see him passing. He said, "You pull me aside and say, I'm going to tell you something." Here we go. What can I do now? What am my guys do? So.
I think that maybe there's some
kind of
a decision.
Which one's
losing the
$1 million?
Of course. That's bottom line.
If we were using Summersworth as a cash cow for all those years, then we would probably feel the same way, I guess. Mm-hmm. But we weren't. So we were the cow. So, anyways, it is what it is. So, but that's good to know, too, I guess. So next steps, then. I thought we were going to be able to be prepared to make a recommendation to the select board tonight, but given this. Do we want to wait to get an official answer from the local police chiefs before we make a recommendation? I don't. If it is a possibility, I don't want to do our due diligence and look at it. So, it's like we've been looking.
Oh, yeah, it's going to take some time. I think we can ask for the RFP.
Mm-hmm.
In the meantime, if all of a sudden one of the two departments say, "Yeah, come on over," and or whatever. We can always stop that process if necessary.
Mm-hmm.
But because it does take time, because we'll have to have both representatives come and meet with me again, because my staff has looked at the estimate so far, and maybe let's change a door here, and
mm-hmm.
this room needs to be a little bit bigger, and let's eliminate this. So you know, there are some physical changes that we'd like to make on the two plans that the two folks have submitted as of yet. At least so if the board asks for the RPF, they say, you know, let's receive it within 45 days or 30 days or whatever you folks decide, then that certainly gives them time to do what they need to do, research and finalize the figures and whatnot, and Charlie time to meet with the building.
And so as part of that process, the RFP process, are we just giving them the dimensions? We're not giving them the actual design, right? They're coming up with the design.
Well, I gave them the basic design, how I'd like to see it.
Right.
You know, you have your booking area separate from your work area, which is separate from your public area.
Right. That's, yeah, then again.
And whatnot. So I imagine that they'll probably, you know, take the design that they submit to us and just twerk them a little bit.
Okay.
We've looked at things like, you know, please make sure that, like, you know, it's generator ready, three-phase electrical. We need to make sure things like that. We're requesting a vent in the evidence room that vents directly outside as opposed to within the building like we currently have now, because every now and then they're with marijuana downstairs. So we need, you know, so the vent in like the evidence room needs to go directly outside. Little things like that,
sure.
That we have a list that we've made.
Right.
Give these folks so they can put it in the final price.
Yeah. I think you some
sure.
Of the facts that you absolutely have.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm just wondering if there'll be costs associated with that. And we'll want to have, the select board will want to have it reviewed by legal counsel, that sort of thing. So
correct.
It will be minimal costs, I would imagine. But.
So how many people are you expecting to bring in RFPs?
Well, I know I'm assuming Grown will and Norton Homes will. I don't know if the select board just wants to put it out there generally for someone like Middleton Lumber or, you know, maybe a local builder from town may want to put in a bid for it or something. So, you know, those folks that knew me say, here are the plans that we gave to everybody else. You know, Grown and New England Homes actually kind of had the jump start this time at this point because, you know, I approached them and said, hey, just roughly, well, I'm just looking for a number to give to the committee. And they said, oh, well, we better now. We'll come up with a price and draw a floor plan for you. So.
I think that we probably should be open to the public.
Yep. Oh, for sure. We'll want to cast a wide net. We won't.
Yeah.
And we typically want at least three bids. Something because of this magnitude, at least. But small projects, we don't always get that. But for this, we would definitely want that.
And what we did find out that by having someone like New England Homes and or Rowan, who have their own in-house design, it's actually a little less expensive because they design it, they build it to their specifications, as opposed to someone who might be doing stick build for us and now has to hire an architect to go out and do those plans. So we have design-build, it is in the long run
right.
Cheaper.
The architect comes up with a plan, we send it out to bid, we get a bid back, and then the project starts, and oh, by the way, it's not going to cost that. It's going to cost a lot more.
And that's
so the design build phase, the price is actually baked in, and if it costs them more, too bad on them. They eat the cost. So
right.
It gives them an incentive not to screw up. What's that?
Those architectural services too, right?
I'm sorry?
I think they do that.
Yes. Middleton? I don't know. But we would welcome them to bid. I mean, anyone. So are we ready then to make that recommendation officially to the select board?
I think we should go forward. It doesn't mean that when we hear from Charlie that we can also
with the caveat
that
if
that
something else
maybe a possibility
a better solution,
right.
Then we would also pass that information over.
Right.
But
right.
If we want to start the ball rolling,
I think
this does take it's going to take Bob and Prue some time to amass the documents to send on. I'm hoping he's going to do it to send on to the select board, right?
Sure.
Okay. That's so.
So this is a recommendation to go up RFP?
With utilizing the, I guess we can't, at this point, can't say the ICF because not
well,
everyone
no, just,
company
you,
does
but
it.
You're just asking for recommendation
right.
For their proposal.
Right.
And you're going to, you may get, you can get at least two different styles.
Right.
And from there, you say, all right, we like this, we know what's going to cost, or we like this one, we know what's going to cost.
Mm-hmm.
So.
And are we going to recommend at this point, unless we heard differently about the Rollins / Main Street corner, that Silver Street is the most viable option that we have at the moment.
At the moment.
So just so I'm clear, we are going to recommend opening up for RFP, but do we really have, so we don't have to pick a lot, because do the lot really matter?
Because they can take that building and put it anywhere.
Right, so you could get RFPs from the builders at this point.
But they can look at the options.
Yeah.
If they want to go down with the options.
The cost would depend on how much site work needs to be done as well, right? So if we can recommend a lot, they can go and look at it and design around that. I mean, I don't know what kind of, it's flat field, they're growing corn right now, so I don't know how much it would need, but it would need a well and all that, I would imagine, but water sources, maybe pretty water sources on that side of the tracks.
They do.
There's water over there.
There's still water there.
Yes, there is.
In that field?
The recycling plant has a great big huge pipe right up there, right from the tower.
The town water?
Yes. Didn't know that, did ya?
Nope.
I'll check that out.
Please check. Yeah, but that's only if you do swap.
Sure.
See.
And, I mean, I think you want to constrain, you want the RFP to be for the most, that it will be compatible with the most constrained lot, and I think the most constrained lot was the one on Silver Street, because you don't want to get a proposal and then have to re-engineer it because it doesn't fit the one parcel that the town actually owns.
Okay.
So, I think you want to, and it's a proposal for police department only.
At this point, yes.
Okay, not municipal, not.
Pretty sure that's going to come up in the hearing.
Pretty sure that's going to come up.
What are we going to do about the town hall?
But if you, if that was going to happen and you were going to make municipal, we would have to have a second floor, is that right?
The Silver Street lot, the town hall would have to be second.
We would have to go upstairs, and you'd have to have an elevator, and that would be that much more.
Yeah.
Fire, it doesn't make sense, there's no lot big enough to have fire and police together, not even that corner, well, maybe, but.
Greenfield Drive, you know, if you're talking 10 acres, you can put all three over there eventually.
Yeah.
But you consider the.
Oh my God, that would be enormous.
I don't know if you want to call it public hearing, but a meeting for public input to kind of gauge the sense of the community about whether or not they would want to build something that could structurally be expanded on later.
I would imagine that would be part of the select board process, definitely. Sorry, I'm just making notes, trying to.
Have a public hearing before the RFP goes.
That part will definitely happen, but I mean, but having that be part of the conversation, sure.
I've designed our space so that we have a larger training slash conference room slash community room, I've labeled as a community room, so that, and it's on the end of the building. So if the town says, all right, let's just build everything, or build two units, or three units, whatever the case might be, that piece that's right here can be utilized by somebody else on the other side of the building, can be in the middle of the building. So more than one entity could use, like that conference room, training room. It has, the way it's been designed, it has its own ADA bathroom for that particular area of the building. So that could be a shared space.
And that's what Farmington was doing. They had their different municipal committees meeting in that shared room. So you could have the planning board, select board, zoning, budget commission, I'm trying to think of budget committee, I catch you eventually, make a run around the horn, could utilize that room. Of course, then you still have the issue of the clerk and tax collector, but.
No, I can't but wonder if that, you know, will be a topic of conversation, you know, what are we going to do with this building?
Oh, sure, probably will.
Do we need to maintain this building? You know, not saying it would happen, but it's possible that people would entertain building with this apartment in the way that it could be expanded.
Sure.
And the only caution I would give is that politically, I think that people open that conversation at their peril, because there's another committed group of people that want to see the town hall stay. So we can argue ourselves to stalemate if we want.
This group only is going to deal with the police road, though. I don't want to, because if not, we're going to spin ourselves in circles, because we did talk about that a little bit at the beginning. It looked like for a while we might be heading in that direction, and then we had a meeting, not the last one, but one before that, and there was folks that thought you would be foolish if you didn't, And then folks thought it'd be foolish if you did, because you'd be biting off too much and people would reject it. So it would cost too much money. I mean, it's going to cost money either way. But yeah.
But
so,
would it really? I mean, to put a second floor, like to plan for a second floor in the police department, would it really be that much more money?
Because really, all upstairs that you'd have to have a bathroom for both upstairs. You'd have to have officers for planning, zoning, Caroline, the select board, and over here. You don't have to duplicate this space. So.
And an elevator
and
to access.
The problem, the elevator is a big expense, and that's about $100,000, roughly, just for that. So.
And really having it. I mean, really haven't gained anything more because you still couldn't have your town meetings there. You couldn't have, you know, your bigger gatherings there because you wouldn't have that.
It would be replacing this space, basically.
Just a space.
It's just
exactly.
A space.
You wouldn't be able to. At least another half, 500 or more of that, you know, just, I mean.
I mean, the expense stuff's already in place. You know, the mechanicals are already in place.
Yeah.
Yeah, you're probably talking another $500,000.
Yeah.
To have a second floor, maybe $750,000.
Yeah.
Is that worth like asking for?
Because I'm sure you know both parties want to be willing to get the final specs for the final RFP. I mean, just ask them. Say, hey, double space up there for these particular offices, and add an elevator. What do you think?
Mm-hmm.
And just do it off to the side.
Mm-hmm.
This is our design, but in the event that they decide to put a town hall there too, you know, an estimate.
Mm-hmm.
I can do that.
Because mm-hmm. You would have plenty of parking. That was over
that was
on Silver,
issue
right? That was something that you had taken into
mm-hmm.
account, right?
Correct, yeah.
So that wouldn't have been an issue. It's more just the physical space.
Correct. Mm-hmm.
After the survey was done, we realized we had a lot more space than we thought.
Mm-hmm.
So.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
All right.
Do you have all parking?
I'm sure they could give you, if they're doing it all, they could give you
oh, sure.
What a second floor is going to be, for sure. And the offices that would be created, for sure.
All right. Is there anything else we want to talk about? We need to talk about.
Is there anything that's, you know, any work to be looked into grant money, potential grant money?
There's no money for the building itself.
Okay.
And if we decide at some point that the community room will be the emergency operations center, there's money to buy equipment for that room. There's money to put a generator in that area. So there is some money out there for emergency operations.
Okay. Good.
But at this point, we're looking at down the road asking money to help us pay for those items.
Yeah.
We can't label that room as the emergency operations center at this point.
Really?
But there is money to outfit the building.
Yes.
Eventually, but just not to build.
What group would I have of residency? I've got a license with my wallet.
Any other questions or comments or things we could have?
So you're going to do the request?
Actually, just doing that, and because I'm going to register to vote anyway. But if there's no proof that I've done it, then.
Why don't you get me to prepare that information? Well, no, we could email it out to all the committee members.
Right.
And if we feel that we need to come back to something, glaring omission, or Charlie's contacts come back and say, come on over, where do we have room for you? I mean, I don't make a glyph people, but then we would definitely want to come back and say, okay, we need to reconsider that we're sending over.
And then the white
one. Exactly, and then the one with property, which is a couple of unknowns. So.
Perfect.
Well, we thought originally would take a month, but.
yeah, I might as well.
Thank you all.
I've got my own dad.
It's only been a month.
It's only been.
Too many is the answer, but. All right, well, thank you all for coming.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you.